Hello everyone, I continue the series of reviews for building a smart home. Today, with a high degree of probability, there will be the final series about hardware for building a smart home based on Home Assistant, namely about the SOYO M.2 mini PC based on the N3550 processor. Today we will see how fast the additional M.2 SSD 825S SATA 3 memory module from Transcend with a capacity of 250 GB works. We will check the speed and the ability to work and boot from two operating systems, Windows 10 pre-installed on the built-in memory, and begin preparing for the installation of Home Assistant, Ubuntu 22.04. This can be said to be the last video before the start of the series of video instructions for the Home Assistant smart home, so subscribe to the channel and do not forget about the Telegram channel, it will be interesting. In principle, the built-in memory is quite enough to install a smart home system. But I believe that there is never too much memory, and the more memory, the more opportunities, for example, for a backup of the system or all settings. The ability to create your own file storage or recorder for video cameras. You can choose the M.2 SSD hard drive yourself, I will give links to some products in the description under the video. I just had it on hand. Transcend M.2 SSD 825S thanks to the M.2 standard, 80mm, SATA 3 interface with a throughput of 6 GB/s and a modern controller, the Transcend M.2 825S SSD drive provides impressive read and write speeds of up to 550MB/s and 500MB/s respectively. This reduces boot time by 1.5 times compared to traditional hard drives. Compact dimensions, only 80mm in length, make this M.2 SSD an ideal choice for ultrabooks and lightweight laptops and mini PCs, thinner and lighter than conventional HDDs, this solid-state drive helps significantly improve system performance while saving space. The M.2 SSD 825S also delivers random read/write speeds of up to 80,000 IOPS, which not only helps the system boot up quickly, but also increases the speed of resource-intensive graphics and multimedia applications. Anyone who has ever held a screwdriver in their hands can handle the installation. Unscrew the screw on the cover on the back of the mini PC with a Phillips screwdriver. Remove the cover. Here we see that there are two options for attaching additional memory. It is possible to attach a standard 40mm, the seat is present, but covered with a film. And in the 80mm seat, a screw for attaching the board is already screwed in. Unscrew it. Now carefully insert the board. It is important not to mix up the keys, here they are on the contact pad of the board. Well, do not use excessive force, if the board does not fit into the seat, check what the reason is. Tighten the screw holding the board. And now screw the cover into place. Before using, let's check if our drive is recognized in the BIOS of our mini PC. To do this, immediately after pressing the power button of the mini PC, start pressing the delete button on the keyboard several times. After entering the BIOS, go to the Security tab and below we see that we have a device P0TS250GMTS825S. We exit. To do this, go to the Save and Exit tab and select Discard Changes and Exit, in the pop-up window, Agree. Preparation. In the Device Manager, in the Disk Drivers section, our device appeared. If you decide to use as a personal computer with the Windows 10 operating system, in order to use the installed disk in the system, you need to create a volume or volumes on it. So to say, initialize the disk. To do this, right-click on the Start icon and in the pop-up menu, left-click on Disk Management. Here a window for initializing the disk immediately pops up. We agree with the GPT partition table. As you can see, the disk is black and there is no space on it. Right-click on the unallocated space and select New Simple Volume to launch the hard disk partition setup wizard. Then, in the window that opens, click Next. Now you can simply click Next, and then the entire available disk space will be created as a separate volume. Or you can enter your own value. For example, split this disk into two disks with a capacity of 100 and 150 GB. I will use the entire one, click Next. In the next window, select the disk letter. By default, the first unoccupied one is selected, for me it is D. Click Next and here we can rename and format our volume. Let it be an SSD. Click Next. In a few seconds, you have a new hard drive ready for use. The System Explorer even opened a window for creating folders or files on it. It's time to test and compare the results. This is the information about the disk that the Crystal Disk Info program displays. We launched the disk test using the Crystal Disk Mark program. These are the results of the disk speed test you see. As you can see from the test results, the manufacturer did not deceive. The speed and recording of large files is about 500 megabytes per second. Not a bad result, considering that I have M.2 SATA, not an NVMe drive, which will have an even higher speed. The speed of writing small files naturally drops a little, but still holds good values of read and write speed. Now for comparison, let's run a test of the internal memory speed. I already did it in the full review of this mini PC, but it is needed for comparison. As you can see, the read and write speed of the built-in memory is almost twice as bad. Only reading and writing very small files is almost comparable. 325 megabytes per second versus 544 megabytes per second for reading. And 208 megabytes per second versus 521 megabytes per second for writing. I think the conclusion here is obvious. It will be better to install a smart home system or a Windows system for work on an external M.2 drive than on the built-in memory. This mini PC will work much faster. For whom these numbers do not mean anything. Let's just take a large file, for example, an Ubuntu installation image and do such tests. Here I am copying it from the built-in hard drive to it. As we can see, the average read and write speed is 116 megabytes per second. That is, a file of almost 6 gigabytes in size was duplicated in about 45 seconds. Here I am copying it from a newly installed M.2 SSD hard drive to it. As we can see, the average read and write speed is 218 megabytes per second. That is, a file of almost 6 gigabytes in size was duplicated in about 15 seconds. That is, a clear difference in operation is 2 times, both in speed and in time. It's time to check whether we can run 2 operating systems on one PC. Windows 10 is initially installed on one disk, and I installed Ubuntu Desktop on the new hard drive. Go to BIOS and in the boot section go to the UEFI Hard Disk Drive BBC Priorities option. By default, boot from the built-in memory is set, and it is called Windows Boot Manager. Boot from the second disk is set as the second item. Let's select this second item, Ubuntu P0TS250GM. Now exit BIOS with saving. To do this, go to the Save and Exit tab and select Save Changes and Exit in the pop-up window, Agree. As you can see, the Ubuntu operating system has started loading, which I installed on the new SSD drive. You can see for yourself that I am in a fully installed Ubuntu operating system, and the internal 64 GB hard drive is also available and the Windows operating system is on it. Turn off the PC and go to BIOS again. Now select in the boot section in the UEFI Hard Disk Drive BBC Priorities option, Windows Boot Manager. Now we exit the BIOS with saving. For this we go to the Save and Exit tab and select Save Changes and Exit in the pop-up window, we agree. And our mini PC again began to load the Windows 10 operating system. No problems. You say, it is possible to do this on a flash drive and a micro SD card. Yes, it is possible. But there will be problems with the reliability and speed of both loading and operation, as in any personal computer or laptop. In the tests of this PC, I showed the speed of work with external USB flash and micro SD memory cards. It is suitable for checking the functionality or one-time use, but I would not recommend it as a working operating system. As you yourself could see, installing an external hard drive in the M.2 slot allows you to increase the speed of reading and writing data by more than 2 times. Therefore, if you want to get a more productive mini PC for your tasks, or a more productive and with a larger memory smart home server, buy an M.2 memory bar and install the operating system on it. Not only does productivity increase, but also the available free space that you can use at your own discretion, install additional programs, store files, music or video. You will find all the links to the products in the description under the video. There you will also find links to my Telegram channel, where new products on smart devices, coupons, promotions are published, as well as active communication and answers to questions. In addition, the description contains a link to the forum, where topics are conveniently divided into categories for easy search of the necessary information and communication. Don't forget to like the video if you liked it, and subscribe to the channel so as not to miss new releases about smart home devices and systems. Peace, goodness to everyone, and see you in the next videos.